the teams from China and Singapore.
Like China rebuilding yet again. Fresh new faces on the circuit. Seems to change every year, but more noticeably over the last 12 months with the directorate of the union moving away from Beijing. And as a result, new younger players being brought in following the national games last year. Fan Dong, who played in the final, contributing a number of these players to the national team now, with very few Beijing-based players actually in the squad. So the future's bright for them, but it seems to be all the time. It's keeping this squad together, giving them experience they need to be able to compete with the likes of Korea and Hong Kong and Japan.
And Singapore really got up for the semi-final clash against Malaysia there. Causeway neighbours, of course, so have they used all the gas in the tank, or can they get up one more time? Because this Chinese team have played really well in periods this weekend. They were in with a shot against Japan earlier on this morning, just couldn't convert their dominance into points. As Dakonel takes the ball in. Oh, beautiful run here from Ishraf, who goes away. Wonderful start to the game from Ishraf, the Wanderers man. Oh, he's taken out. I think it was a Wanderers man, although I've got him down here in the team list as Oldham. But, certainly one of the fine young players.
Yeah, he had a big influence in the previous game that they won. Some great pace. Thought he was going all the way, but some great cover defence as well by the Chinese.
Really determined to win this game, Singapore, in memory of Michael Grice, who sadly passed away this morning. The president of the Singapore Cricket Club and the vice president of the Singapore Rugby Union. Brilliant rugby man and fantastic guy. And we will miss him for sure. Rest in peace, Michael Grice. As China come away this time. And they decide the kicking is the best option. It's Wong Wei who picks up the ball as well. And he's found the right way to the try line, Wong Wei.
First
blood to China here in this plate final.
That's a great use of the kicking game again. There were bodies between Wei Wang and the ball carrier in midfield. Didn't risk the risky pass. Looked up, calculated kick. Fantastic time to kick and create the fine opening score for China.
Wang Jiha with the conversion attempt. Just astray, just slightly to the right there. So 5-0 is the score.
Narrowly missed conversion from Jianghua Wang. China lead Singapore by 5 points to nil.
Wang makes his way back to halfway to restart play. Good to see one of Asian rugby personalities, Izzy Kadir, doing so much development work in the last couple of years, taking the reins of the Singapore team, and he's obviously done a pretty good job this weekend. Singapore punching above their seeded weight.
Yeah, Izzy has been fantastic for Asian rugby, working for AFU on a tournament, organising tournaments, spreading the word around the region. So it's great to see Izzy involved with Singapore rugby directly.
Another man too from Singapore, Ridzal Saat, with his appointment to the IRB. Congratulations to him. Spent the last few years at the Football Association of Singapore, but to back in the rugby fold. It's good to see Ridzal back as well. Not here this weekend. Max takes the ball up. Martin Butler. And here's Daniel Mark Chow. He gives it to Mohammed Zaki, who's had a great tournament himself. Zaki really worked on his pace as well, but a foot race between Zaki and the Chinese player Liu Chow.
Mike Machow has been around for some years in the Malaysian setup, both in and out in the team, out of the team. And what do you know about him, the number three for Singapore?
Oh, The Singapore team, yes. He was a player who spends his time in the 15s game between second row and loose forward, and couldn't get any playing time at the Singapore Cricket Club, so decided to transfer to Badoc for more match play, and I think that's been a good thing for him to do. John Lee there as well. Now, Zaki takes it away from the untidy line-out, playing into the sun here, a bit hard to see. It's Butler, though, who steps and commits a couple of defenders and drives to the line. Butler, he looks like he's got it down. Yes, the referee agrees, and it's try time for Butler, and that will level things up with the conversion to come. Oh, in fact,
no, he's checked with the in-goal man. He's checked his in-goal touch decision. It's been called
out. Howie Rowlands, I thought he'd hoisted his arm in the air to signal the try, but asked for the extra help, and why not when you've got a man stationed there at the dead ball zone? So got excited too soon there for Singapore.
I sense that excitement. You can tell you've been living in Singapore for some time, Mike.
Yeah.
That passion.
Always good to see Singapore do well. They've had some great success in the sporting realm in the last couple of months. A slew of Commonwealth Games medals.
Especially fantastic in the new facility in the new stadium.
Oh, fantastic.
And some big sporting events and sporting occasions at that stadium in years to come.
Yeah, no, it's certainly a great thing to have, and can't wait to see it full. We've got the Suzuki Cup football coming up later this year, and whenever the Singapore national team play football, they're strongly supported. But we had a great crowd at the World Club 10s in June. Saw the Auckland Blues defeat the ACT Brumbies in the final. It's strange, though, because Piriwipu was playing in the tournament, and London Welsh were there, and lo and behold, a week later, he announced his departure from New Zealand rugby. So sort of transfer market going on there as well, as we see China breaking away, but he's put his foot in touch. That'll be an interesting season for London Welsh as they make their way in the Premiership.
Yeah, and a fancy team to go up. Bristol tipped with all their big spending and ex-internationals and quality players there. But London Welsh fronted up in both games and outplayed them. So, and now London Welsh seems to have really invested in some quality players as well, in Piriwipu and a number of quality players coming in from the Southern and Northern Hemisphere.
Chanda Israf, oh, he telegraphed that pass, and the telegraph was well received by Wong Wei, who goes over for his second try and shows a little and exuberance too, diving over. Good to see.
Number 11 from China, the flying wing again, Wei Wang.
Oh, Wei.
Well, that was a shame for Singapore. Looked as though they'd scored to level. It denied the try being held up, and then China bursting back.
Yeah, harsh reality of sevens rugby. Should have been, could have been 7-5 to Singapore.
Chan Wang for the conversion. There's Wong Wei. Good to see him playing with a little bit of panache, and he read that play well from Ishraf. Was never on too with the numbers that China had outside. Shame from Ishraf. Won't slow down his flair though, a confident young man, the 20-year-old, studying business at the Republic Polytech. Chow can't get his hand to the ball, but Zaki gets it, and he gets a big hit on him too from Liu Guanjun. Hardy enough though, Zaki. Dakano to Ishraf, who throws a bounce pass off his left hand, and trying to try to hold the man up. They can't do it. Here's Chow, who's been everywhere so far in this game. Good man to have in the tight end loose. And China again come away. There's a bit of crossing though. Bit of obstruction that will deny Fung Li Wei the try. So Singapore with the penalty, and we've played well over 8 minutes now of this first half. So due a little break at half time, you'd imagine. So they're going to put this one out, Singapore. I'm not sure if they're aware that, in fact, as Dewey Rowland's going to know, he's whistled half-time. So Singapore down 12 points at half time against this very strong and powerful Chinese team.
Yeah, good efficient performance first half by China, Mike, and but unfortunately just one little turnaround, one little incident, which was the held up over the line. Some great work in the in-goal area by the match official, I think it's Warren Meader from Hong Kong, keeping his eye on the play for his referee, who'd been bowled over by the contact area, and critical play. And then China capitalising on a bit of sloppiness in midfield and securing a 12-point lead at half-time.
One of the keys to Singapore's victory against Malaysia was the second half performance of some of the fresh legs, Gunasekara, Naresh and Jaleel as well, coming on and adding some fresh legs. So they're not out of this game, but they need to probably score first in the second half here. Also assisting the Singapore team is Clarence Lam, who also was one of their stars back a decade, and brother of professional golfer Lam Chi Bing. A bit of a talented family there, the Lambs. No, he was excited to see Roger Randall again, who's with the Japanese team this week. He last saw him at the IRB Sevens, I think, about 10 years ago.
What role is Roger playing?
Oh, he's the spot coach, so I guess he's dealing with the backs. I'm not exactly sure. But,
so referee Rowland is just about ready to start us off in the second half of the men's plate final.
So a bit of a wall Singapore. To scale here for the Singapore team. 12 points down as we start the second half. And there's Jameel already creating an impression. Big hit, he's like a human cannonball, Jameel. Stocky build and really throws his body around. That was a big hit to announce his presence at the Hong Kong Football Club, and he played really well against Malaysia too, throwing himself at the big Fijian players. No fear. Chan will put the ball in here to this scrum and thinks about the blind side and gets Ashraf into a bit of space. Good timing on the pass. Jameel to Zaki. Zaki and Jameel again. I love the way he throws himself at the contact.
Fantastic work rate. Could have a big influence over this second half.
And he's there at the base of this ruck, and he's going to have another go. Is the support with him? Yes. Squeezes the ball out. It's a sloppy though, and China have got onto this one and turned it over. So now they've got a chance here. Trying to get a ground through Lu Peng. Support play from Liu Chao, and away goes Wong Wei again. And this will be hat-trick time for Wong. And he's certainly proven to be the difference in the two teams when he's had the space.
Yeah, unfortunately for Singapore, Mike, what's happening here is that, you know, you don't go toe-to-toe with any China team. They're very big, they're very physical. What Singapore need to do is to get the ball away from the contact area into the spaces. They'll get some rewards. But again, three or four contact areas by Singapore with contact with ball in hand, and then eventually being out muscle turnover ball, difficult to defend, then turnover ball. And so China now 19. Pushing themselves away into a position where Singapore really need this score to stay keeping this this plate final.
Singapore finishing 10th in the series last year, 11th the year before, so even with this loss, sixth position, so a good start for them. Really turning over the apple cart with their performance against Malaysia. So here's Jameel under the ball. Shapes to pass, but again, crashes and smashes his way into the hefty contact, and he's held up as well here and loses the ball. So China again on the attack, really putting Singapore under the hammer. And there's loads of men out here on the right. And beautiful pass and draw from Fung, who puts his teammate Kai Wun into the clear for a try.
As you identified at the beginning of the game, Mike, the Singaporean team had to put such a big effort into that semi-final plate win against the rivals Malaysia. Malaysia hugely physical, and now unfortunately for Singapore, perhaps the amount of effort they had to put in to get to this final is now telling on them, with the bigger athletes and the stronger athletes of China really controlling the contact area now and the physicality in defence.
Fair play to China. They were a couple of loose passes and knock-ons away from defeating Japan in the quarterfinal as well. So hopefully they'll build some confidence from this performance. It's been a nearly performance from them, but they've come away as plate victors by the looks, with just 3 minutes left of the second half.
Certainly it's a strong-looking China team. And again, looking ahead to the Asian Games, they'll create a real threat for medal positions in Korea later in September.
The Chinese players there absolutely squashing. It's Dukano that was under the ball. In fact, it was Keith Areola who's come onto the ground. Warm reception for him, the Oldham player. Naresh gets them out of the 22. Areola to Ishraf. Switch of play, but sadly, play breaks down, and not playing the whistle there. Singapore just dropping their shoulders. Jalani, who made the handling error. Oh, and there's another handling error. So a play advantage to Singapore. Rollins on the spot to make sure what was going on.
2 minutes to go.
We should salute the voluntary force of the Singapore Rugby Football Union here, led at the front by Andrew Lee, ex-national prop, doing a sterling job out there in the heat. Andrew, how are you doing today?
I'm very well, man, very well.
Enjoying the rugby?
Yeah, it's good. It's a good day.
Enjoying the aircon here in the commentary booth?
Enjoying it a lot, yeah.
All right, you've had enough. Now get out, please, and get on with your work.
Andy retired at the ripe old age of 27. You know, probably with the six more years in him. So, but a major administrator now of our domestic leagues and controlling the game in Hong Kong. But I'm sure we'll get him back into a national shirt.
Cleric,
he's a very young prop in relative terms.
Yes, indeed. Just approaching his pomp, really, as a prop. So China sealing the deal here with their fifth try. And he's got four, a bag of four one way. So he's done very well, the flyer. And well, he didn't get much time at the start of the tournament, but he really impressed as a young player coming into the system, taking every chance that he was given. And good to see him in the starting lineup and really making some hay while the sun beats down here at the Hong Kong Football Club. Just a minute to go. It's all been one way traffic, sadly, for Singapore. And China with a 31 points to nil lead.
Singapore nil.
Naresh gives it the little step and manages to evade a couple of defenders. Loses the ball in the contact. So advantage here for China. Wong Wei, the star of the show so far in this plate final. Get smashed, but they'll come back for the scrum for China.
On the last play of this plate final, I think, mate, off the scrum. We'll see a Philippines approach with China trying to play. I suggest in the heat and reservist manager, we may see China pop it off the field and settle for the plate win at 31-0.
So four games left in this tournament, the third and fourth playoffs for men and women, and then the cup finals. Some exciting rugby to look forward to, and Dewi Rollins blows his whistle shrilly to signal the end of this plate final, and a well-deserved victory for China over a brave and plucky Singapore team.
Yeah, excellent plate final. Disappointing for Singapore not to have competed, but I think that the game in the semi-final against Malaysia took it out of them. and well-deserved plate win for China, who, as you rightly said earlier in the tournament, pushed Japan all the way. So a great win, great for confidence boosting for China as they build to the next event and indeed further down the line to the Asian Games.
So coming up next should be the third and fourth player for women, Japan taking on Kazakhstan. China women's